It's the summer of 2001, and a new Rob Schneider comedy has just opened in theaters, The Animal. You assume, since it's a Rob Schneider movie, that it's probably terrible and not worth your time. But you decide to check out what critics are saying anyway. Of course, the negative reviews dominate the press. Like Scott Chitwood of ComingSoon.net, who said, "I wouldn't be surprised if teenage boys walked out on this one." Or Glenn Whip of the Los Angeles Daily News, who said, "Fails to develop its ideas or jokes in a way that would satisfy anyone over the age of 10. But then, in the sea of negative reactions, you see one glowing review from David Manning of the Ridgefield Press, who said, "The producing team of Big Daddy has delivered another winner!" Exclamation point. And maybe that positive review convinces you to give The Animal a shot. The only problem is, David Manning doesn't exist. Well, in truth, there was a real Dave Manning, but he was a medical and industrial supply salesman, pretty far from being a film critic. But Dave Manning happened to be old college friends with Matthew Kramer, a man who would go on to become the promotional director at Sony. Kramer borrowed his friend's name with permission when dreaming up a fictitious film critic for the express intent of giving glowing reviews to films released by Columbia Pictures, which is a subsidiary of Sony. This was a deceptive advertising scheme dreamed up by Kramer and the senior vice president of creative advertising at Sony, Josh Goldstein. The real Dave Manning gave his consent to let his name be used for the reviews, but had no further involvement. He also said after the fact that he didn't even like The Animal. But Kramer and Goldstein's ploy worked for a while. In fact, it worked quite well. The fake film critic David Manning reviewed a number of Columbia Pictures releases and had excerpts from his reviews used in all manner of promotional materials for the films. He called Hollow Man one hell of a scary ride. He called Forsaken a sexy, scary thrill ride. He wrote This Year's Hottest New Star about A Knight's Tale, and when Vertical Limit came out, Manning said, "Movies don't get more exciting than this." To make matters worse, even though this David Manning film critic didn't exist, the Ridgefield Press that David Manning supposedly wrote for does exist. Ridgefield is a small town in Connecticut, and happened to be where Matthew Kramer grew up. So he picked the local paper from his hometown as the place of employment for this fake critic. The real Ridgefield Press was not in on this scheme. And this is how Kramer and Goldstein were eventually found out. It was John Horn with Newsweek who first sussed out that David Manning didn't exist. And when he contacted the Ridgefield Press, they confirmed that nobody named David Manning ever worked for them. In fact, the review section of the Ridgefield Press was written entirely by a father and son duo. It's a very tiny paper. So what happened when Sony was caught faking reviews? Well, not much, unfortunately. Sony refused to accept any liability for the fake reviews, but did publicly denounce the actions of Kramer and Goldstein. Sony went as far to try and argue in court that they had a constitutional right to print these fake reviews and advertisements on the grounds of free speech. If this disgusting misuse of free speech protection makes you feel sick too, then don't worry. The judges threw out their arguments and ordered Sony to pay out in two different court cases. One was leveled by the Connecticut Attorney General, in which Sony settled for $326,000, and the other was a class action lawsuit in which Sony was ordered to pay out $1.5 million. This $1.5 million was divided up into $5 refunds eligible to be claimed by anyone who saw Vertical Limit, Hollow Man, The Patriot, or A Knight's Tale. These payouts were nothing to Sony, a mere drop in the bucket, as every single film that David Manning had a review attached to brought in dozens of times that amount of money in profit. As with most big business enterprises, lawsuits like this are just the cost of doing business, unfortunately. But were Kramer and Goldstein at least held accountable for this scheme? Yes, in the absolute lightest sense possible. They were both suspended without pay for 1 month, then fully reinstated in their positions. Nothing else happened to them. At the exact same time as this whole fake critic fiasco was going down, Sony was also embroiled in a fake audience fiasco as well. TV ads were running supposedly real audience testimonials from moviegoers as they walked out of screenings for The Patriot. Except, Sony later admitted to planting several employees in these screenings, and giving them scripted blurbs to recite as they exited the theater, such as, "It's a perfect date movie." And as if that wasn't bad enough, Fox, Universal, Artisan, and other studios all admitted to doing the same thing. It's not really all that surprising, but it is disheartening to see such deceptive practices so widespread in the entertainment industry. That was going to be the last piece of this story, but then I found one last odd little wrinkle. In my research, I stumbled across this bizarre website that purports to be David Manning's personal website, with a landing page where he refutes the claims that he doesn't exist. The page also says, quote, "I will not be driven out of my profession by media outlets looking for a scandal at the expense of my life. I will continue to review movies even if the entire world believes me to be a phantom, for movies are in my blood." How strange that someone would make this website, even after Sony admitted to making David Manning up. There are even reviews for other films from 2001 written here with Manning's dumb over-the-top praise. He calls Atlantis the greatest animated film of the last 15 years, calls Swordfish the greatest cybercrime movie of the last 15 years, and calls Evolution the greatest comedy of the last 15 years. He also says that Sean William Scott will win Best Supporting Actor for Evolution, and that Jordana Brewster will win Best Actress for The Fast and the Furious. As if he needed any more evidence that this couldn't possibly be a real critic. What confuses me about this is why anyone would go to so much effort to perpetuate this myth after it had been openly debunked and denounced by the very creators of that myth. On the About page, the site even claims he has a wife named Brenda and two children named Claude and Monique. It even claims he has a cat named Puff. Why? What is the point of this? But perhaps most interestingly, it claims that David Manning's first novel, Beyond Everything, will be published by Kreskin Books in April. Now, there's no year listed with April, but let's just go ahead and assume that that vague April has already passed since the last update to this site seems to have been made in 2001. But there is no Beyond Everything novel, if you were wondering. And as far as I can tell, there's no publisher called Kreskin Books either. However, there is a magician known as The Amazing Kreskin. And this magician wrote a number of books throughout his lifetime. One of them was titled, How to Be a Fake Kreskin. Is that the joke of this whole website? How to be a fake? I feel like I'm unraveling some old internet puzzle here, but I don't know why anyone would bother to arrange all this. But I digress. That was the story of David Manning, Sony's fake critic. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe to Brickwall Pictures and check out some more of my stuff. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.